discussing about the microwave bench setup. So as you can see here, this whole setup is called as a microwave bench setup. It works at a certain frequency. That frequency ranges from 8 to 12 GHz, which is nothing but the X band as designated by the IEEE standard. So if I tell about the components involved in the microwave bench setup, is gun power supply, gun diode, a plunger to generate particular frequency, because by moving the plunger we can create oscillation, and that oscillation will produce certain frequency which will be transmitting through the waveguide, and that will be carrying the power. Other component is isolator to protect the transmitting unit from the reflected signals, because always when we will transmit the signal or whatever signal is generated through this gun diode, it will be transmitted for a load. But any reflected signal due to certain mismatch which reflects back, it can harm the gun power supply. So we need an isolator which is a non-reciprocal device, and it absorbs the reflected signal, and actually it isolates the input from the output. That's why the unit is called as an isolator. Other thing is the other component is pin modulator. In this pin modulator we have a pin diode. Why we use this? Because this is a high frequency RF signal. That RF signal directly cannot be detected at the receiver side. Okay, so we use the pin diode and we modulate this high frequency signal at certain low frequency signal. Here we are using the 1 kHz frequency for the modulating purpose. Other component is the attenuator. There are two attenuator. One is called as a fixed attenuator and one is variable. Variable means when we can rotate the knobs and we can control the magnitude of the signal. That attenuator is called as a variable attenuator. Okay. The other component is frequency meter. This component is used to measure the frequency of operation, at what frequency our power is carrying inside the waveguide. Because once we have generated through this gun power supply one frequency, now it is traveling inside the waveguide. So that frequency will be captured inside the cavity and we will get a dip at the VSWR meter, and we can measure the frequency through this frequency meter. Now other component is the cross sectional waveguide. Okay, in this we have an opening. Through this opening we will be detecting the signal, and that signal transmitted through this coaxial cable to the VSWR meter. Okay, so whatever signal we have transmitted, so when we are detecting here, is nothing but the modulated signal through pin diode. Okay, now here comes the VSWR meter. I will explain the VSWR meter. We see two readings, black and red one. Red one correspond to the power when we are measuring the power readings, and up we can see the above SWR and the expanded SWR when we are measuring the SWR readings. Now here we can see this total 5 knobs are there. So basically we are going to use these two knobs and this one. This is to fix the level of power. If we are keeping it at the 60, it means available power is minimum. When we are keeping it at the 0, means the power available here is the maximum power. So slowly, if we are not able to generate the maximum power, slowly we will use to move from 0 to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60. Like this we can rotate and we can able to detect the power. These two are to maintain the gain. If we are not able to fix the knob at the higher position, we will be rotating this gain knob, and we can make the fine tuning by adjusting these two knobs. Okay friends, now I will be starting from the beginning. This is the gun power supply. Here we have three knobs. Okay, so one is for the modulation of the frequency, another one is modulation of amplitude. So these two knobs controls the pin diode signal here. Okay, when we are controlling the modulation, it means the depth of modulation is controlled through this pin diode. And then magnitude and frequency, it means we can vary the frequency also for the modulation, and we can control the magnitude also. These two knobs is for seeing the voltage available for the gun diode and the current available. If you are keeping at the up portion, we are seeing the voltage. If you are keeping at the down side, we are seeing the current. And this one is to increase the voltage value and the current value simultaneously. Any one we can control. So we are like, suppose we are having this at the
the knob upside. So we can see here 0.00. Now if I am increasing slowly, it's like now see 1.8, 2.24. So the question is till what value will go? First we should know what is the threshold voltage for the gun diode. Gun diode is a negative resistance coefficient device. So when we cross the threshold voltage, it works as an amplifier. So for that here, it is around 4 volt. So we have to go beyond the 4 volt to cross the VTH. So now it is around 5 volt. We are keeping it here 5.16 volt. So by this knob, we can control the voltage. Okay. By this knob, we can control the modulation amplitude. And by this knob, modulation frequency. So these two should be at the higher position. Both should be at maximum. Maximum modulation frequency, maximum modulation amplitude. And the voltage should be at 5, above 5 it should be. Then this is a plunger which controls the depth of the length of this waveguide. So when we'll move the plunger, we are actually, what we are doing, we are changing the motion in horizontal manner. So by changing this motion, we are generating a particular frequency here. So as you can see, I have set it at certain position. Okay, now the second one, we have to control the attenuation. We have to see it should be at minimum position. It should be fully open. Anti-clockwise we are rotating and it should be fully open. Okay, and then we have to maintain, we have to see that frequency meter should be at the minimum position, at the down. Anti-clockwise we have to rotate and we have to keep it at minimum position. And the cross line, when we see the slotted line section, there is this plunger, it should be fully inside, kept fully inside to detect the electromagnetic signal. Okay, and then we can see here, we have to this is the constant.